Welcome to Everyday Cooking with Anne. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon, and the reason we are going to share today's video, it's called about the Luscious banana bars, which they are, with a burnt butter frosting. They're so amazing. And why would I want to make these today? Well, if you want to take a look at my bananas down here, they look ugly, do they not? But they are perfect right now for making the most wonderful tasting banana bars. So let me show you really quickly what I'm going to do. I cut them already a little bit right here so you can see just how ripe they are. And normally you would think, oh, I'm just going to throw those bananas out. But think about this. Okay, I'm thinking if I make this whole pan of banana bars, you know, I'm going to eat them. But you need to think differently. You need to think, who during this whole COVID crisis could use a little leaven from your baking? So many people do not bake, and you can think of some single person or family that would be, their spirits would be lifted if you dropped something like this by. So I thought today, hey, I'm going to make these banana bars and see who I can go visit today, because it's a Sunday afternoon. It's a perfect time to go visiting. So we're going to go ahead and make these luscious banana bars with burnt butter frosting. Once you make these recipes even one time, they're going to be a family favorite, I promise. So you can see just how I actually put these in the freezer last night thinking, I don't know when I'll do this. And I thought, no, we're going to make these today. So I'm going to go ahead and take out, see how very ripe that is. I'm going to just take all of that juice and everything from that banana. And you need about 3 to 4 bananas to make this recipe because it is a bigger pan than a 9 by 13. If you'll, Wayne will show you the pan here in just a minute, but it's a 15 by 10 jelly roll pan. I have several of these pans in my possession. I use them all the time just because I need that size for a lot of rolls and other things that I make. Okay, so we're taking these bananas out. Now, this just goes to show you that you can freeze these for another day and then take out your bananas and it'll be perfectly fine. So if you have ripe bananas and you think, oh, I should have done something with those, go ahead and put them in the freezer and think, I'll do this another day, which is what I did. So I'm just going to kind of mash these all together and you can see how juicy they've become. We're going to be putting those in our mixture in just a moment. Okay, so what we have in the recipe today is we've got 2 cups of flour, and we're going to put in the flour 3/4 teaspoon of salt. So that's 1/2 and 1/4. 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Put that in there too. Mix that up. So that'll be all ready to go in just a moment. We're going to be having walnuts in here, and I put more walnuts in because I love nuts, and it just, the banana and nuts together are a perfect combination. You can see I'm also going to be putting in some 1 cup of sour cream. I have 2 whole eggs, 1 1/2 cups of sugar, and 1 cube of butter ready to go in. And also we're going to be putting in 2 teaspoons of vanilla. You just heard my oven. I have that set not at 350, at 375 degrees. That's what we're putting this batch of banana bars in for. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is add my butter into my mixer along with some sugar. I'm going to go ahead and mix this together first. These bananas should equal about 1 3/4 cup of banana. I'm not even going to measure it because it works perfectly, but 3 to 4 bananas depending on the size. Just wanted to make sure that's clear. Usually your butter should be softened, but if it's not, it'll work just fine too if you have a nice mixer like I have, like a KitchenAid or Reveal like I have. Okay, that's about done right there. Now I'm just going to go ahead and put in the sour cream. Okay, the sour cream in this recipe is honestly the bomb. It's what makes it really special. Now, of course, you could make my wonderful banana bread out of these bananas too, but I just thought of this today and I thought I haven't made these for a while, and I should have thought of it because they're so amazing. I'm going to also put in 2 teaspoons of vanilla. Vanilla with banana is a great combo, and I think that's why we're adding this much. But not only that, because we're making a larger batch of what we're doing. And I'm going to add the eggs right now as well. Okay, let's get this started. Okay, I'm just gonna slip these bananas right in here too. And if they're not quite as ripe as the ones that I showed you that I have, go ahead and mash those up really, really well before you put them in the mixture, okay? But mine were really nice and ripe, so they're going to incorporate very well. As a matter of fact, the more ripe, the better the flavor of this banana bar. So don't think about putting like a regular banana in this recipe. Wait a few days until it's nice and speckled and maybe even almost black, like I have. Okay, I'm gonna add the flour and all the other dry ingredients right now. And you don't want to beat this a whole lot, just till it's incorporated, because you want to have the texture be just kind of like a banana muffin, so you don't want to totally beat it to death. Okay, now I'm going to add, my recipe calls for a half cup, but like I said, a cup of walnuts. Chopped. Okay, we're going to take this off and scrape down. Oh, one nice thing about this recipe too is that we will be baking these for only 20 to 25 minutes, because of course when you have a larger pan like I have here, we'll spread it out. It won't take very long. Anytime you make something with a bar cookie that's in a large pan like this, it won't take too long. Now you can see that I have greased and floured my pan. That's what the recipe calls for, but I think I've actually used Pam spray before, or parchment paper, whatever you like to use as the releasing system you want, so that they come out of the pan very easily and without breaking apart. Also, of course, you can see from this is a great recipe for feeding a crowd. I've done this before with my Texas sheet cake and different things like that, and it's just another different way to make everybody happy with grabbing a little bar type dessert. So I'm going to spread this evenly. You can see kind of how thin it is, but you want to make sure you get the corners, but spread it out nice and evenly. I'm going to go put these in my 375 degree oven. I'm going to put it on for 20 minutes. I've noticed lately my oven hasn't been as hot as it should be according to recipe, so I finally got an oven thermometer to see if I can calibrate it better so that I know that my baking is going to be right. So I will be checking this to see if it's done in the center at 20 minutes, but this will go per recipe 20 to 25 minutes. So I'll put this in the oven now, and we'll see you back in our banana bars in the oven baking for about 20 minutes. So while that's baking, I've put a cube of butter on medium heat in a pretty much large saucepan, because this is how we're gonna make the glaze frosting that we're doing. It's just about all melted. Now you wanna keep it right on medium heat. You don't, this is called a burnt butter frosting, but you don't actually want to burn the butter. You want it turning a nice amber brown. So I want you to watch this. When it starts boiling and starts turning the amber brown, then we want to turn it off. And I'll show you the other ingredients that we're putting in. This is a very easy frosting. This is what's so great about it. It kind of reminds me of Texas sheet cake. You make the cake, then you come over to the stove and make this really decadent topping that has nuts and everything in it, and that's, you know, to die for. But it's so simple, and you can feed a crowd with it, which is even better. We'll be showing our amazing sheet cake for chocolate sheet cake coming up in one of our other videos, so make sure you see that one too. It's the same process, but the most amazing recipe I've ever tried for the Texas sheet cake that you might be familiar with. So here we go. This is on medium heat. You can see it's bubbling and boiling, which is supposed to do, and we're going to watch it carefully. Now, while we're waiting for that, I want to show you some of the other ingredients we're going to be putting in. And this is my own recipe, okay? I added this to the recipe. I have a tendency to do that. I change recipes once I see them and go, oh, what could make this better? So we will be adding in maybe about 3 ounces of cream cheese melting into this too, to go on the frosting as well, with the confectioners. We have 4 cups of powdered sugar, confectioner sugar. Okay, look and see. It's kind of, you can see it's foaming up and bubbling up a little bit. We have it still at the medium. Okay, I can see. Can you see it starting to turn a little bit brown right here? Just keep stirring this right here, and I'll let you know when I think See that brown? This, I know it doesn't sound like it's going to be good, a burnt butter frosting, but honestly, it's to die for. Okay, it's done. You can see how brown it is now. I turned it off immediately. And I'm going to go ahead right now and add in 2 cups of this powdered sugar. Oh, you know what? I forgot one other thing I got to get out of the refrigerator. So let me go grab that real quick. We need 3 tablespoons of milk. So I just added 2 cups of this right now. And I'm going to go ahead and add in my cream cheese and let it start melting a little bit too. And my 3 tablespoons of milk. Now, you can make this without the cream cheese if you don't have any. It's still a great frosting, but I personally think this makes this frosting really special as well. If you're a cream cheese fan like I am, I'm always thinking, well, what can I put in this to make it better? This was a winner. Okay, I'm going to turn this back on to low heat right now just to melt this up. You know, I do a lot of catering, and people love my dessert buffets and the different types of things that I put on them. You've probably already seen my, my little tarts, lemon and chocolate and cherry tarts. You know, the Texas sheep cake bars that I'll show you how to make. These, I'm going to finish the frosting we have for the banana bars. I've already melted in the cream cheese, and I had already put 2 cups of the powdered sugar in, and I measured out exactly 4 cups, so we need to put in 2 more cups of powdered sugar. This seems like a lot, but it's going to be covering an entire pan of banana bars, so just add this in. Okay, this is about mixed up. Stir it really, really good. Whip it up. I've already turned the heat off on here, of course. I'm just mixing everything in. Now, the thing is, we're going to be taking out our banana bars shortly, and while they're still warm, we want to add this burnt butter frosting. I'm going to put in now another 1.5 teaspoons. So there's a lot of butter in this recipe, a lot of vanilla, 1 and about 1/2 teaspoon, 1 to 2, again. Okay, this is all ready to go. When we take our banana bars out and I show you what they look like, we'll add the topping and we'll be, then you of course want to cool completely because you want to have a nice cool crusted top of frosting on the banana bar. We're back and we've taken our banana cake out of the oven and it's absolutely perfect. You can see because I didn't overmix it, it's nice and spongy, lightly golden brown. There's little pockets here and there that show the banana, lots of banana in here. What we're gonna do, and I've let this rest now since I took it out of the oven for about 5-10 minutes, so it's not piping hot. We didn't want the frosting to seep down into it. We want it to be on top. So it's still very warm to the touch. So what I'm going to do is just start going like this. So then I'll start spreading it around to the edges. Here's all of our banana frosting. So we kind of want this to melt into it as well. Sometimes you have to kind of move it around a little bit so that it covers everything evenly. You don't want too much in the center. And you want to make sure those side pieces are have just as much frosting as the center. So you kind of have to just whirl it around, and what's so nice about it is that it's still warm. You can see the little flecks of cream cheese that are still in here. Now, if you didn't want to put all of your walnuts in the cake and you wanted to decorate these with walnuts, half your walnuts in the cake, half out the cake, you could do that. But we're just doing this. Okay, I'm spreading this evenly. Now, this is where you want to make sure you don't cut into this either yet because it's not quite ready, because this will be kind of a hard icing in about a couple of hours. So you want to cool this completely before you dive into it. We're going to come back and show you what it looks like when it's completely ready to serve, and we'll see you then. Here we are at the end of the segment. We have taken our frosted banana bars and we have cooled them and I have cut them, and let me just show you just how beautiful this looks. It's beautiful, it's moist, delicious, and the smell of banana is amazing. I hope you enjoy this. This just looks like heaven to me right now.